Hello children, a very warm welcome again. So welcome to our next computer class. In the last session children, we have completed with our chapter number 3, that is log on to Access. And I hope now you are familiar with the screen of the Access and how to open the Access and how to create a database and how to create a table. So till now we have learned these things children, that how to create a database, how to create the table, how to create the fields in that, what type of data should be there. Okay, so these all things we have learned till now. So today children, we will be continuing with our, we will be starting with our next chapter, that is chapter number 4, working with tables. Now actually how to work with the tables, that we are going to learn in this chapter. So children, if you have a table already, you are working on a table, so how to open it and how to edit it if you want to make any changes, that we are going to see today. So first let us see what is the table. So table is a database object that contains the basic information you wish to store. Like in previous lessons, we have already seen the examples like students' information, or in any bank, the information of the employees, or any office, right? Regarding their salaries, regarding their address, and so many things like phone number, basic data like name, surname, right? So these all things we have seen the examples of database. Next one, it contains rows and columns. So everyone knows rows means the record, right? And columns is nothing but the fields, different fields. Like we have seen an example of student information. So what different fields we take children? That is the name of this child, the division, class, activity, and phone number, address. Okay, so these are the different fields which are in our columns, and row is nothing but a record of a particular child. Then it is used to store information in an organized way. This we have seen in the first chapter itself, that in an organized way how do we store the data in the database. A table can have a maximum of 255 columns and unlimited rows. Now you can see here, 255 columns means a huge data we can store in our database children. So there we can create 255 different fields, right? Columns means nothing but fields we are creating. And the unlimited rows, that means unlimited data you can, the records you can store of a particular organization. Next one, you cannot have two tables with the same name in the database. Very important children, when you are saving any table, so you cannot create two tables with the same name, you cannot save it. So you have to give a different name to the tables. This is very important. Again, when you are saving the table, you should know this. Okay, so let us move ahead. Now the next topic is opening an existing database children. So if you are already working with some table or some database children, and every day you have to work with that, every day you have to make edit it, have to make changes, add a record or delete a record. So anything editing if you want to do, first you have to open that existing database which you are working with, right? So how to open an existing database which you have already created? Let us see that. So the first step is click on office button. Now everybody knows which is the office button children, right? So here you can see the circle one, and in that the squares are there four. This is an office button. When you will click this, the step, select the options from the drop down list. So these are the options. So we have to open an existing database. So we will click on open. Can you see here open? Yes, we have to click the open option button from the dialog box. Then next one is choose the folder or drive that contains the database. One window will open where you will see all your existing tables or existing database, sorry children, where you can choose the whichever you have to work or edit. and then the selected required database will be selected, and then you have to click on open button, and then the selected table will open in the data sheet view. So these are the steps, children, for opening an existing database. Next one is moving through records. Now once you open the database, suppose there is a huge data of suppose 2000 children, data of a school. So you have to go for a 200th one, whichever is that the record at 200 or 250. So how you have to move through the records, children, right? So what is the best way to move through the records? Let us see. So it is very convenient to move through the records in MS Access using the navigation toolbar that appears at the bottom of the data sheet. Now what is that navigation toolbar? Let us see. Now you can see here, children, if you remember in our last session, I have shown you this in my video. This is the navigation toolbar. Okay, now the buttons over here, I have numbered it. Like this is number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. There are 6 buttons. The functions of the buttons, let us see. The first button, if you click, it will take you to the first record. Suppose there are 2000 records. So if you click that button, it will take you to the first record. After that, there is one more button, children. Button number 2, you can see here. It will go to the previous record. Like suppose you are working on the 15th record. If you press that, you will come to the 14th record. That is a previous record, right? Next one is the button number 4 I'll come to. That 4 will go to the next record. So if you are working on the 16th record and you press that button, it will take you to the 17th record. Okay, so previous and next. And the very first button was the first record. It will take you directly to the first record. Now next one is the 5th button. If you see here, it will take you to the last record. Suppose you have opened your database and you are on the first record and you want to go to the last record to add one more record, right? So you can click directly the 5th button, children, which will take you to the last record. And if you suppose have to make a new entry, then you can click the 6th record. If you see here, here is the 6th one, children. So it will take you to the new blank record where you can enter the new record. Okay, now left one is the 3rd one. Very, very important. This is, it will display on which record you are working currently. Like you are working on a 16th record currently, right? So it will display 16 out of 200 or whatever is the number of records. And suppose you have want to search for some, like you want to directly go to the some 251 record. Okay, so you can directly type there, children. It is not mentioned in the slide, but pay attention. You can type there like 251 and it will directly take you to the 251 first record. So this is how you can work with the navigation toolbar. It is at the bottom of your screen. You will see at the bottom of your table. Next one, how to do the editing records in the table. Okay, so editing means you want to change something, or you want to add something, or you want to delete something. This all comes under editing, children. So changes in the database can be done in various ways. To edit records, scroll through the records. You can directly scroll through or use the record navigation buttons which I have just shown you to find the records to edit. Now click the cell where you want to make the changes. A pencil icon appears to indicate the edit mode. Now children, when suppose this is the one picture, I hope the this is not much clear, but in the next video when I'll show you practically, at that time I'll definitely show you, children. So you can see when I click on this title blocks, okay, the title block, and then when I start entering the record, children, you can see here, here is the pencil icon comes, if you see. Okay, so that pencil icon means you are currently in the editing mode, like some changes you are making over there. Okay, so pencil icon appears to indicate that it is a edit mode. Then type the information in the field, whatever changes you want to make. And then after typing, click outside the row. Okay, click somewhere else, like to the next row or to the upper row. Okay, then you can see the changes are applied. So this was about the editing records in the table, children. So we will stop over here, and in the next session we will see few more things on how to work in the table. Thank you so much.